it's your boy, Barca Boy 103. Today we're going to be reacting to the Barcelona news over the past 24 hours, and we're going to touch upon some of the big stories that have been happening over the past, I'd say, 6 to 7 days. So much news to cover, but before we get into it, make sure you guys smash that like button and try to get the 200 likes on this video. It would be very much appreciated, and of course, hit that subscribe button, and let's get into it. Let's start off by discussing Barcelona's search for a new number 9. Of course, Luis Suarez left last summer, and ever since then, we have not replaced him. The only number 9 in the squad currently is Braithwaite. But Lawrence from ESPN came out with a big article talking about Barcelona's number 9 position. He starts by saying that Barcelona have increased their scouting for the Real Sociedad striker Alexander Isaac. The current Barcelona board assumed that the signing of a center forward will be one of the new president's priorities. It would be extremely difficult for Barcelona to sign a big money forward like Mbappe or Haaland this year due to the financial situation at the club. Thus, they are drawn to alternative options, which include Alexander Isaac and Darwin Núñez. Sergio Aguero and Memphis Depay, both of whom are available free, are two names that are on the table. It will be up to the new president to decide who to sign. Of course, Memphis Depay is a request from Ronald Koeman. Thus, the possibility of his signing will largely depend on the fact if Koeman continues at the Camp Nou. So ESPN are reporting that Barcelona are currently looking at 4 number 9s in the likes of Alexander Isaac and Núñez with a transfer fee and the 2 free deals of Aguero and Depay. Let me know down below, out of those 4, who would you pick? For me personally, out of those 4, I'd go with Memphis Depay. Of course, low risk factor is probably the best out of the 4, I'd say, currently. Of course, Aguero on his day is, of course, better than Depay. But right now, with age and all that sort of stuff coming into factor, I think Depay is the best option. But we all know that the dream number 9 that we all want as Barcelona fans, and of course, Laporta wants him as well, and that is Erling Haaland. Now, Fabrizio Romano came out saying that if Borussia Dortmund fail to qualify for the next Champions League, it will be really, really difficult to keep Erling Haaland. But of course, his release clause of 75 million will be only valid in the summer of 2022, and it will be hard to negotiate with Dortmund this summer. So after this report came out from Romano, Mainarelo did an interview with the BBC, and he gave a big hint to Erling Haaland's future. He said that currently only a maximum of 10 clubs can afford to sign Erling Haaland and give him the platform he would like after he's been at Borussia Dortmund, and out of those 10 clubs, 4 of them coming from England. So you might be wondering, what are those 10 clubs? Of course, Fabrizio Romano decided to let everyone know what those 10 clubs were. Those 10 clubs are Manchester City, Manchester United, Chelsea, Liverpool, Real Madrid, Barcelona, Juventus, PSG, Bayern Munich, and Borussia Dortmund. So as we all know, it's going to be, of course, very, very difficult for Barcelona to bring Erling Haaland in this summer with the financial situation of the club, but I would keep it out on Dortmund making the Champions League. If they don't, expect the rumors to be flying, expect Laporta to make some absolute miracles to get him, because we all know for a fact that Laporta does want to bring Erling Haaland to Barcelona. And if Borussia Dortmund don't make the Champions League, he's definitely going to be pushing a move out, because he doesn't want to spend, you know, a year in the Europa League wasting his talent, wasting his career, and all that sort of stuff. So I definitely look out for that for sure. Also want to quickly mention Fabrizio Romano in that same report where he talked about Erling Haaland. He also talked about Ricky Puig going to AC Milan. He said that AC Milan were highly interested in signing Ricky Puig. They tried to open talks with him last summer, but Barcelona did not allow it. From December onwards, Barcelona declared Ricky Puig as untransferable, and the deal never advanced. One of the main areas where Barcelona have the strength this summer for sure is the defense, because the defense over the past few years has been absolutely dreadful. And over the past week or so, we have actually been linked to quite a lot of defenders. Let's start out with David Alba, who's probably the best out of all these defenders. Alfredo Martinez came out saying that some presidential candidates have already contacted David Alba and even offered him contract premieres divided over several seasons. It's of course no surprise that Barcelona are very, very interested in David Alba. I think he's closer to joining Real Madrid currently than he is Barcelona, but wait until the president gets elected. Whether it's Victor Font, whether it's Juan Laporta, both of them are going to be fighting for that David Alba signature, because of course he's a quality player. He can play in many different positions, but mainly of course Juan Laporta has very good connections with David Alba's agent, and he wants to bring David Alba to Barcelona. So if Juan Laporta is elected, I'd watch out for that for sure. He's going to be trying to persuade David Alba, and if we do get him, and it's going to be a huge upgrade on our defense, and of course it'll make the Madrid fans a little bit salty. Another center back we've been linked to over the, I'd say, the past like 8 months is of course Eric Garcia. We all know the deal is confirmed, as we all, like, I'm not going to repeat myself for the millionth time the deal is done. The deal is done, but Pep Guardiola came out in a press conference yesterday pretty much confirming it from his perspective as well. In his press conference, Guardiola was asked about Eric Garcia, saying, look, he hasn't been playing at all. It's been Ruben Diaz, John Stones, I'm Eric Laporte. Where's Eric Garcia? He unfortunately said that, look, I can't play Eric Garcia because, of course, his contract is ending. And what he said was he's going to play, I think, at Barcelona. Barcelona don't buy players because they're an average player. It's because they are a top player. In the last 2 games, he was not selected for Manchester City. It broke my heart because he doesn't deserve that. Maybe you don't know him, but you can't imagine what Eric Garcia means to me. He's like a son. He was the guy during lockdown last season that was our best center defender. He never made a mistake, not even one, and he even played in the Champions League quarterfinals. So following those quotes from Pep Guardiola, Fabrizio Romano came out saying that Eric Garcia will join Barcelona in the summer as a free deal. Confirmed by Pep Guardiola, he will sign a contract of 2026. No other clubs are involved, i.e. Arsenal and PSG, in the race. And another defender that's been linked with Barcelona is, of course, Pau Torres. Now, Pau Torres is a quality player in Villarreal, Spain under-21 player. very, very solid. And the reason why he's been linked with Barcelona is because Santi Cazorla came out and said that. Of course, Santi Cazorla is currently playing under Xavi and El Saïd in Qatar, and they just won a title. And he came out after the game talking about Xavi, saying, look, I think he's ready for Barcelona. He's a top, top coach, all that sort of stuff. And they asked him, did Xavi tell you about any other players that he likes, maybe at Villarreal or somewhere in Spain? He said that, yes, he told me about Pau Torres. He said that Pau Torres is like a great player to me. Xavi asked me about him. He is young, but has a great personality. He has a lot of Barcelona style. He gets the ball very well, and he has very good vision of the game. So if Xavi's ever appointed the Barcelona manager over the next few years, or maybe even next season, definitely watch out for these Pau Torres rumors. They're going to be flying all over the place. Even without Xavi right now, I'd take Pau Torres. I think he's an absolutely quality player. He's probably one of the best young players in La Liga, if not in the world. But let me know down below when you take Pau Torres at Barcelona. And the final defender we have been linked to is the left back Juan Bernat of PSG. Mundo Deportivo came out saying that Juan Bernat is expected to return to action soon after being injured since last September, but his future is still uncertain. If he doesn't renew his contract with PSG, Barcelona or Sevilla could be a possible destination. For me personally, I wouldn't mind taking Juan Bernat at Barcelona, especially on a free deal, but of course the Barcelona board currently and a lot of the culés want to get Jose Gaya. I think also Laporta wants to get Jose Gaya. Victor Font, he's more open to Juan Bernat simply because he's on a free deal. But Jose Gaya is going to be dirt cheap. As we all know, Valencia are in turmoil in terms of finance and they're going to be selling all their top players. Jose Gaya for me is definitely the best option, but Juan Bernat on a free deal isn't bad at all. Now I want to give you guys a quick update on the presidential election. Of course, yesterday the first debate took place with all three candidates. I did a recap on that. You can check my last video or you can click the eye on the screen right now. After the debate, two squads invited Juan Laporta, Victor Font, and Toni Freya to the Camp Nou box for this Wednesday's Copa del Rey semifinal second leg against Sevilla. So with Juan Laporta being in attendance, we may make that comeback. Also, I had to show you guys something that happened between the three presidential candidates, which I thought was absolutely hilarious. So all three of them went on the Catalonia TV and they were asking questions about, you know, their candidacy and what they were, their project, all that sort of stuff. But they were also asked to do a challenge. They were asked to draw the Barcelona badge with no reference, no nothing. I'm not too sure if they were giving a time on it, but they were asked to draw the Barcelona badge with no reference. So they had nothing in front of them, just with their mind, draw the Barcelona badge. They had a whiteboard and a marker and they were asked, you know, just to draw, just as a little bit of a challenge. So first one you can see on your screen is Juan Laporta's. You know, that's, you know, it's with no references. I think this is very, very good. Of course, this is having, you know, the round edges. This is probably, you know, the old Barcelona badge. It looks more like that. Don't know what that arrow is. Maybe it's like Cupid for love or something like that. I don't know. But it's pretty decent. Then you have Toni Freya's. Now, Toni Freya's, I think, is something that you expect from a toddler. But, you know, he got the gist of it, right? You know, he's got the cross, the stripes, the FCB in the middle of the ball, the stripes like that. The, you know, the outside of it isn't really that great. But definitely Juan Laporta is better than this. But this is not, you know, that bad. Then you have Victor Font. Somebody please tell me, what is this? What is this? I have no idea what this is. Is this Batman? Like, this right here, ladies and gentlemen, is Victor Font trying to attempt to draw the Barcelona badge. Let me know down below what you think the best badge was. For me, definitely, yet again, another victory for him is Juan Laporta. Now, the next topic I want to discuss is the Barcelona manager position. As we all know, Ronald Koeman is currently the first team coach at Barcelona, and he signed a contract for 2 years. First year he's currently doing, and the next year can be terminated by the new president that comes in. Javi Miguel came out with the current stance on all the presidential candidates in regards to Ronald Koeman. He says that only Toni Freya guarantees that Ronald Koeman will continue as the Barcelona coach no matter what happens. Laporta maintains that his future solely depends on the upcoming results, and Victor Font wants to replace Koeman with Xavi. Now, a very interesting report came out from ESPN saying that Barcelona have never made an offer to bring in Marcelo Gallardo. Abidal, his former teammate, was interested in his way of working, but it never advanced. Before Setien was appointed, the three coaches before him in the pecking order that Bartomeu wanted to appoint was Ronald Koeman, Xavi, and Erik ten Hag from Ajax. And all three of them at the time rejected the proposal to replace Valverde as the Barcelona manager. Now, what surprised me about that report is that Erik ten Hag was approached to be the new Barcelona manager and he actually rejected it. I didn't know that at the time. Maybe I did, or maybe that just completely flew out of my mind. I don't know. But that's quite interesting to me because I know a lot of Barcelona fans liked him after bringing Ajax to the semifinals in the Champions League. A lot of Barcelona fans wanted to come in. Of course, he was under Pep Guardiola at Bayern Munich as well during his time there. That would have been an excellent appointment, so fair play to Bartomeu for having him on that shortlist. Now, reports were coming out from Raquan last night saying that Mikel Arteta is one of the options for Juan Laporta's candidacy to become the Barcelona coach if Ronald Koeman does not continue next season. There are many options that Laporta's candidacy has to replace Ronald Koeman if need be, and Mikel Arteta is one of them, but of course, he isn't the only option on the list. Just want to inform you guys that that rumor is absolute BS. As we all know, Raquan and Gerard Romero are very, very reliable people, but they got this one absolutely wrong. Do you know why? Because Juan Laporta came out a month ago in an interview and he was asked, would you take Mikel Arteta as your Barcelona coach? And he laughs, so. Clearly, Arteta is not a target for Juan Laporta. This is just the media, again, trying to fight against Juan Laporta becoming the new president. Because, of course, Arteta is not doing too well with Arsenal right now. So, they're trying to link a weak manager to Laporta to, you know, bring down his votes. Because, of course, the election is going to be in, you know, 6 days. Very, very poor from Rack One and Gerard Romero as well. Very, very ashamed of them because they got this one absolutely wrong. Now, the biggest news coming in over the past 24 hours is in regards to the Barcelona gate. Reports are coming in that with reference to the Barcelona gate scandal, police are regularly visiting the club's office. The case has been under investigation for months. There have been 6 extensions of summary secrecy. Arrests are not ruled out. Reports are coming out this morning from COPE saying that the police have been searching the Camp Nou offices for evidence regarding the Barcelona gate since 9 a.m. They have found a few employees and have summoned executives who were involved in the scandal. After the report came out from COPE, Alfredo Martinez came out saying that the second investigation after the June last year that the police are conducting regarding the Barcelona gate scandal, most of the club employees are currently out. Arrests are not ruled out. Now, after all these reports came out, a few hours later, Ken Nasser came out saying that official former Barcelona president Josep Maria Bartomeu is going to be arrested. That's right. The former Barcelona president Bartomeu has been arrested this morning at his house. He was chilling at home, drinking a cup of coffee, thinking about nothing. Yo, you're being arrested. This is just absolutely fantastic news. Of course, everyone in the Barcelona board of Bartomeu is being arrested. The former CEO of Barcelona, Oscar Grillo, and the legal service advisor, Ramon Gomez, have all been arrested by the police in reference to the Barcelona gate scandal. Now, you might be wondering, why are they arresting Bartomeu? Maybe they don't have enough evidence. Maybe they're just doing this as a publicity stunt. That's not the case. Marca came out saying that the police will not arrest you if there is no concrete evidence in the case. Bartomeu is in real trouble and the presence of his hands of the police is an unfortunate end to the second president of Barcelona, whose end will be tragic after Rossell. Now, two of the presidential candidates came out giving the reaction to the arrest of Bartomeu. Firstly, Toni Freya came out saying, too many people want to hurt Barcelona. We won't allow it. You'll never walk alone. So basically, that tweet right there from Toni Freya has completely ended his hopes of becoming the Barcelona president. There is no way in hell he will become the president. He has links to Bartomeu. He was under the board of Central Rossell. Please, please, please do not make this man the president. Get this cretin out of my club. And also, Juan Laporta gave his reaction. He said it's not good news nor pleasant for Barcelona. He did not have a good management at the head of Barcelona, but he's still a former president of Barcelona, and this is shocking news. For me personally, this is not shocking news. I am absolutely over the moon with Bartomeu being arrested. He is going to be going to jail. He's going to be going to prison for every bad thing he did for this club. And I'm so, so happy. And of course, the man who's probably the most happy right now is Lionel Messi. Bartomeu may have won the battle in the summer, but Lionel Messi won the war. So just to end off this video, I want to give you guys some of the news updates around Barcelona at the moment. First one coming in from Sport saying that Ilaix Mariba was scheduled to travel to Lleida this morning to play for Barcelona B, which of course happened yesterday, and Barcelona B ended up winning that game after his good performance against Sevilla and Pedri's injury. So after that report came out from Sport, Marca came out saying that Ilaix Mariba moves ahead of Ricky Puig in the pecking order and could start against Sevilla in the second leg of the Copa Semis. Javi Mengel came out with an injury update on Sergio Roberto, saying that Sergio Roberto was expected to be out for a month, but he could end up being out for 6 to 7 weeks as a precaution since the club doesn't want to risk another relapse. Mundo Deportivo came out with a Coutinho injury update, saying that Coutinho still has a swollen left knee after being operated on his external meniscus. It's a setback in his recovery. Coutinho was expected to return for the first week of April, but now that'll be pushed back. Cat Radio came out saying that Ronald Araujo has only discomfort, not an injury, and he'll be fit for that Sevilla game on Wednesday. And finally, Rack One came out saying that Pjanic has a small strain in his ankle and is a doubt for the match against Sevilla on Wednesday. So that was my reaction to the Barcelona news. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you leave a like. Let me know your thoughts down below on everything we discussed, because we did talk about a lot. And make sure you guys hit the subscribe button, and I'll see you guys tomorrow for the match preview between Barcelona and Sevilla in that Copa del Rey semifinal second leg. Take care, and Forza Barça. Thank you.